يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد, all praise and thanks is due to Allah Azza wa Jal. Peace and salutations upon Muhammad ibn Abdullah, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. Peace and salutations upon his family, upon his friends, and upon all those who try to emulate him until the end of time. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. We welcome you to day number 7 of our daily reminder series. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us. In today's reminder, we'll be looking at a very important aspect of the life of a mu'min, of a Muslim. And that is following the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, following his lifestyle, following his way, following everything that he did and he taught us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول رسول وأولي الأمر منكم. That, O you who believe, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and those of you Muslims who are in authority. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, O slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O mu'minun, that obey Allah. There's no doubt about this, that we need to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well as those who are in authority above. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he teaches us a very important lesson, a very beautiful lesson, a lesson that we need to implement in our lives. فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ. And if you differ in anything amongst yourselves, then refer it back to Allah and refer it back to His Messenger. So there's an issue. There's an issue, an Islamic issue. And we're not sure what to do. So we go back to the Book of Allah, and we go back to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. And if you believe in Allah and in the last day, this is what you are going to do. That if you differ on an issue, you go back to the Book of Allah and you go back to the prophetic teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to us, ذَلِكَ خَيْرُ وَأَحْسَنُ تَأْوِيلًا. That is better and more suitable for the final determination. So, O slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, turning back to the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is compulsory. It is not a choice. I cannot wake up one day, I believe in Allah, but I don't want to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I don't want to do what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. I don't want to follow the tariqah, the manhaj of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And look at the next verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and that whomsoever or whatsoever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives to you, then take it, and whatsoever he forbids you, then abstain from it. So this also brings up a very important concept, my beloved brothers and sisters in Islam. And this is that if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he never did ibadah or a certain type of ibadah, then I cannot come and introduce this into the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu, he mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Man ata'ani faqad ata'a Allah. That whomsoever obeys me has obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whomsoever disobeys me has disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught a very important lesson to his companions. And this is how we got this message, is that obey me and you will obey Allah. But if you disobey me, then you have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The importance of following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sa'id ibn Musayyib, may Allah have mercy on him, he once saw a man praying more than two raka'at after sunrise, the beginning of Fajr. So as we know, there's only two raka'at of sunnah before the Fajr Fard pray. So he saw this man, and in some narrations he says it was in Masjid al-Nabawi. He sees this man praying, making a lot of sujood, making a lot of ruku. And he told the man, and he spoke to him, and he told him that this is not the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so stop. Do not indulge in this. The man then replied to him and he said, O Abu Muhammad, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to punish me for praying? And this is a common answer. This is a common discussion. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to punish me for celebrating Mawlud? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to punish me for celebrating the 27th of Rajab, Isra and Mi'raj? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to punish me for reading Quran in a group? For making adhkar in a group? See the response that Sa'id ibn Musayyib gives. He says, no, but he will punish you for contradicting the sunnah. And this, my beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, is the punchline. I will repeat it. He says, no, but he will punish you for contradicting the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those that do not just give lip service to the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but we implement this and we do this through action. And also, part of loving and following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is protecting the sunnah. And part of protecting the sunnah is to speak out against people or against actions that goes against the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those that follows the sunnah to the best of our ability. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون.